So, as usual, didn't really have a good intro for this video that I did day of, so here I am, day that I'm editing, doing my intro. This is the new normal, I guess, for me. I'm gonna try to get better at this. But anyways, the day started out just like any other. That scared me.
Just like any other.
The day started out just like any other trip with my parents. I forgot my SD card. I don't know what it is about them, but they make me forget my SD card for my camera. I don't know. I left it in my laptop. So we were almost halfway there and I realized it and I was like, so we had some other things to stop and get. We were planning on stopping at Walmart or a auto parts store anyways for my parents' car because they needed a new light bulb. So we're like, I was like, can we just go to Walmart so I can get an SD card while we're there and you can get your light bulb there? And I'm like, sure. So we decided to just stop by in Cleveland because it's on the way and Cleveland has a Walmart and a bunch of other places there. So on her way in, my mom sees CVS and she's like, oh, let's stop there and I need to get this shampoo that I have a coupon for, it's gonna expire or something. So it was like we're on the way to the hike and the whole thing just turns into like a shopping spree. Like we have to stop everywhere to get random stuff. But we did eventually make it to Benton Falls, which you will see later. But we're gonna jump right in to me at Walmart getting my SD card. So I had to get 64 because that was the largest they had. They only have 32 or 64. Safely. The way Google Maps took us was down like a gravel road and wasn't expecting that. So Benton Falls Road is gravel. If you're wondering, if you don't want to go down gravel road, I suggest staying on 64, which goes by the Ocoee River, and then you can get onto Oswald Road, which is where the falls are off of from there. I don't know why Google Maps took us the other way. I guess I thought it was shorter, but you have to go slower on a gravel road, so wasn't shorter. So depending on what kind of route you want to take up the mountain, those are my suggestions. We're going to go back, Oswald, to the Ocoee River. That's the plan. But we are here now, and Benton Falls Trail number 131. I don't know what that means. Correction, my mom pointed out that it's Benton Springs Road. Not Benton Falls Road, I remember that wrong. But yeah, that's a gravel road you don't want to take. So, assuming that this one is this and you start here and end up here, mm-hmm. That's what we're gonna test out and see if that's accurate or not. So we've passed the beach and the lake, which is really the ant trail. And come up to more signs here. So we're at a crossroads of trails here. And yeah, it points this way to Benton Falls. So here we go. Already starting to go downhill some, but it's very gradual. I haven't seen any stairs yet. And this path is very simple. I mean, there's some washout areas and some loose rocks and tree roots to watch out for, but nothing overly dangerous, I would say, yet. We'll see what happens further up, because as you know, if you've seen my 2 waterfalls in 1 day video, Greater Falls was definitely an unexpected surprise. Like it seemed, started out super easy, and then all of a sudden it turned into a nightmare. So you never know with these things. Oh, this is interesting. This is definitely like a washout spot. And look, another sign. See what this one says. Oh, so this is another way that you can go and loop back. So we probably could have taken a shortcut instead of the way that we went. So some of this stuff is actually pretty flat. And a lot of sand that's clearly not natural to this location. But there are a lot of rocks and stuff. And we saw a family of people on bikes go by. So I've already tripped like 3 times. Because, as we know, tripping is my thing. I've already tripped 3 times. So, I think that's a new record for considering how easy and flat this trail is. But I guess that's why. Because all of the trails I've done more recently have been more going down the mountainside. More steps involved.
Watch out.
Is that a bike? So for the most part, the trail's really easy, but there are some patches like this where you can tell it's muddy a little bit on the slicker side, or soft, but we've seen a lot of mountain bikes, which is fine, I guess, except for one guy was like racing through and was like shouting that he was coming, but he wasn't slowing down, so that was kind of scary, because if you weren't paying attention or if you were listening to music or something, you might have died. So I would say this trail is heavily used by mountain bikers, so proceed with caution if you decide to hike. Some more blackberries that I saw before. I thought they were raspberries, but those are definitely blackberries. So like there's one.
There might be black raspberries.
And there's one. It's pretty sandy though. Should I eat it? I've eaten wild blackberries before on a different mountain trail closer to my home. Well, you can hear the water, and there's a sign, Benton Falls this way, so that's the trail we came down, so you just kind of have to backtrack to here. I don't know why I said backtrack. I meant switchback. More of a switchback. Oh, I guess this will... I can't multitask on this hike, apparently. Oh, there's stairs now. Maybe I'll be fine on stairs. No promises. These are actually nice stairs compared to some that I've been down previously in the past. No handrails, but they're not super steep or narrow. So I don't think handrails are really that necessary. So now we have gained a handrail, and it's obvious why, because this is slick and muddy. And considering my trail record today of tripping, I'm gonna stop filming now so that I don't die. Thank you. So the question at hand has already been, are these blueberries or elderberries? Because they're pretty small, as you can see. I don't know. I've never seen an elderberry out in the wild, even though I know they grow wild here in Tennessee. But you'll have to tell me. Also, I carried that blackberry all the way down to the water, thinking I was going to rinse it off because it was sandy, because it was like on the underside of the bush near the path, which is, as we know, sandy. And right before I got to the falls, I noticed that I was sweating so much that my hand, like, it was turning purple from it. So I was like, I just need to eat it. So I ate it, and it was super tart because it's really small and tiny. So I'm guessing whatever this is going to be really tart too. We'll find out shortly. So I'm going to jump in here and say that I never did film my experience eating the blueberry. Yes, I did eat it. And yes, it is a blueberry. It tasted exactly like a blueberry. And it wasn't even tart. It was actually really sweet. So I guess because it's a wild blueberry, so it's smaller than the ones you buy at the grocery store. And that's why it wasn't tart, because that was like full-grown normal big size for it. I don't know. But yeah, if you are out in the wild and you decide to eat a wild blackberry or blueberry, just, I mean, obviously be cautious, because you never know if that's actually what it is or if you're eating something poisonous. Just be smart about it. That's pretty much all I have to say. I just ate one of each. I ate one blueberry and one blackberry. So it's not like I was eating a bunch just to be safe, and I was totally fine because they were totally fine. But yeah, that's all. I just wanted to kind of interject here and say that. So I wasn't videoing, obviously, but I got to right here because I was going to rinse off my feet in this water, and a huge snake just splashed real quick and went that way in the water underneath. So that's fun. But I should be fine because obviously he's scared of me. But the beach is literally right there, so that's kind of scary. I have my sunglasses in my backpack, but when you exit the other way, you get this awesome... Man. If it wasn't like summertime, you'd be able to see better like some of the mountains in the distance over there. But since it's summertime, the humidity's kind of high. Plus we still have some of that Sahara dust, I think. But there's the Ocoee River down there. I think that's the Ocoee. I don't really know. Making things up. And there is yet another overlook. And I did confirm that is Lake Ocoee right there. And then it kind of juts off and there's like a dead end. So that right there is a dead end. But this is Lake Ocoee, and it goes around and is the river, which is what we're really ultimately headed down to. The road that we're on goes down there. But yeah. Really pretty. So, I definitely recommend taking this road up instead of the other one, because we've already seen two overlooks. Looks like there's another one here, which is pretty crowded. Yeah. So there's a third overlook, and we're not even like halfway down yet. So, definitely recommend taking this way up instead of the way that we went up, because it's also paved and not gravel, so that also helps. The end of today's video. Another note, I asked my mom after the hike what she thought. Being from Florida, she's not a big fan of stairs and long hikes, And she said she really enjoyed it and that it was worth it to see the waterfall. And as you saw, it was pretty flat. The only stairs were really just to go down to the waterfall, which is 65 feet tall. So gives you a rough idea of how many steps you have to go down. It's not bad compared to the other waterfalls that I've done recently. So yeah, I definitely recommend this one if you want to see a waterfall but have trouble with stairs, or you know, can't really go too many stairs. However, the hike is 1.5 miles out and 1.5 miles back, so distance wise it is a little bit on the longer side, but it's not bad. So highly recommend. And if you want to see some more details and pictures, I'll have them in my blog post, which I'll leave linked below. And give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, subscribe, and I'll see you next week.